Hey guys, okay, so I know that I've made hater videos before, and discussing them and talking about how I love them and stuff like that, but I feel like it's a growing epidemic, so you know what, the more the merrier, and let's just all have a hater party. But like 100% serious, I was inspired today to make a video because of something that happened to me yesterday. It's actually a really sad story, but I'm gonna share it with you, so yeah, I'm just gonna start. Okay, so me and my friend were out getting lunch yesterday, and we were supposed to meet my other friend later in the day to go shopping or whatever, or just hang out, but we had some time, so she suggested that we go to a park, so I was like, oh, okay, and it was really, really, really nice out yesterday, so we went, right? So we're just sitting, and we're sitting on, like, a picnic table, like a wooden picnic table, do you feel me? Yeah, so we're sitting on that, and then, like, there's other people in the park, obviously, because it's, like, 2 p.m. and, like, people go to the park at 2 p.m. There was a group of guys beside us, like, that were sitting on a picnic table as well because there was, like, 10 lined up. They were sitting, like, three picnic tables down from us. And they were just, like, guys. Like, I think there was, like, 4 or 5 of them. And they were straight guys. They looked like they were maybe last year in high school, maybe 1 year out of high school, I don't know. Like, I remember I had seen them when I got to the park, but they really didn't cross my mind until now. So this park is like pretty close to a school, and it was right around the time that school was like getting out, I guess. Like elementary school was getting out. So me and my friend were talking, we weren't talking about like anything around us, like we weren't like commenting on the guys or commenting on the grandma in the background. We weren't talking about any of that, we were just talking about like our own stuff. And then out of the corner of my eye, I see this little boy, and he's obviously gay because he has like the cutest little outfit on. He has, well, I guess that's stereotyping, but I mean, I have good gaydar, so this kid is gay. And I mean, the first thing I thought was, oh, he's so cute, like his outfit is so cute because he had on these little blue shorts, he had on like this white V-neck, a backpack, and he was carrying like a sketching pad, right? So he was just walking through the park, and I remember thinking for a split second, oh, that kid is so cute, like he's such a cute little kid, right? Like he's gay, he's so young, and he looks adorable, like I love his style. He's probably like 14, 13 or 14, I don't even know. So he decides to sit at the park bench like two away from us, because there was a line of park benches and then there was another one a little bit further down. So he sat on the one closer to the water, and then he just opened his sketching pad and started sketching, right? Like, I thought at first that he was writing a diary, but then later I figured I was sketching. But, so we're talking, and then all of a sudden we hear these guys like start laughing and start pointing at this kid, right? And like, we're just turning our heads, right? Because they weren't doing anything, like we could just hear them. Like, he couldn't hear them, but we could hear them because we were too away from the group of guys. But they basically started throwing stuff at him. Like, they started picking up, I don't know whether it was like rocks or whether it was like garbage. They started throwing them at him, and this little boy was alone. And it just broke my heart because, like, not only is this disgusting, because, I mean, come on, you're throwing things at a little kid that's younger than you, that's brave enough to come to the park, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know, I just think that it was truly disgusting, and me and my friend were so bothered by it. I mean, they did it a couple times, and then they stopped, and they started up again, and you know how guys are, like, they're just like, hoo, 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 yeah, bro, like, that's so sick, bro. Like, what's fun about that? Like, you're throwing rocks at someone, like, you're bullying them, you're straight out bullying them. And it's not funny, it's not fun, it's not cool, like, you look like an idiot. So basically they kept on throwing stuff, and then me and my friend just both got up and we walked over and sat with him, and they obviously stopped, you know what I mean? Like, you can throw anything you want at me, like, I don't even have to say it, but I think that it's kind of obvious that I've gone through the whole bullying thing, and, I mean, I still go through it to this day. Every single day I go through ignorance. Every single day I go through stupidity, you know what I mean, that I have to deal with. So me and my friend went over and talked to him, and, it turns out his name was Jared, and he was such a cute little boy. And I mean, like I said, I've gone through that same thing. Of course people have thrown stuff at me. Of course people have called me names. It's not that big of a deal to me, just because I've overcome a lot of things in my life. But I mean, to someone that young and to someone that brave, I don't know, it was like literally like a flashback. Like, when I was watching them throw stuff at him, I actually wanted to shoot them in the face. Like, it was so bad. Basically, I'm just applauding Jared because, I mean, it's kids like that out there that make me really, really happy and make me proud and give me inspiration. I'm making this video because of that little boy, Jared. I mean, you know what? And it's the kids that are bullied that come out the strongest, and you know what I mean? Have the best personalities and are the best friends because they've been through so much and they taught themselves how to get stronger and they deal with it. I mean, I don't know what Jared's thinking now, but I hope that he's not down about it. I hope that, you know what I mean, he grows from it, because when we talked to him, he seemed pretty cool. He seemed like he was really mature. He was drawing actually anime, and I mean, I've never drawn anime, so I can't relate to that. But I mean, it was amazing. He was so talented, he was so smart. And I mean, honestly, if those guys that were throwing things at Jared were to even talk to him for 5 minutes, they honestly probably would have liked him. And that's something that I can relate to my life so much. Okay, listen, like in my personal life, a lot of the time people will size me up in a matter of 2 seconds without even talking to me, without even, you know what I mean? Just because of the way I look. It's obvious that you're gonna size someone up when you see them, but a lot of people in my life have written me off within the first second of seeing me. I don't wanna get to know him, you know what I mean? Like, I don't want him around me, da 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 da. But you know what? If you were to give me the time of day and to give Jared the time of day, I'm sure we would impress you, and I'm sure you'd love to hang out with us. I'm sure you'd be blowing up my cell phone, wanna hang out. You know what I mean? Because I know I have an amazing personality, and I know that I'm fun to be around, and I know that I'm a really, really good friend, and I think that that's what everybody needs to see in themselves. I mean, people are assholes. People are always gonna make you feel bad about yourself. And that doesn't just pertain to gay people. I mean, obviously, I'm just speaking from experience. I know personally, a lot of my friends' friends are, I can see, like, cautious of me, or that's why there's this huge problem with straight guys being friends with gay guys, because it's, they don't wanna be seen as gay, or they don't wanna be around a gay person. But you know what? I have a lot of straight friends, and they're my good friends because they're open-minded. And you know what? You know what you need to say to all of those people that aren't giving you the time of day, aren't giving you any time to express your personality or express what you have to offer and what you have to bring to the table? You know what you have to say to them? You have to say, fuck you, because you're not gonna sit around and wait for people to come around to you. You're gonna move on with your life. You're gonna have new friends. You're gonna have better friends. You're gonna have better experiences. You know what I'm saying? And that experience yesterday at the park was really, really sad, but really, really uplifting and inspirational as well, just because when I saw them throwing things at him, I was obviously brought down so much and I was so sad. But when I went over there and talked to him, I was really, really surprised about his personality, and I was surprised that he wasn't taking it that bad. You know what I mean? He knew that he was better than them. And this is one thing. If people are trying to bring you down and bully you, they're obviously beneath you. They're obviously jealous of you. So they're trying to bring you down with them. And the one thing you have to realize is you're above them. You can walk away, or you can give them what they want and give them a huge reaction and swear at them and scream at them. You know what I'm saying? Or you can be the bigger person and just know you're better. You guys know this, I say this 100 million times a day. I live with no regrets, and that is the best way to live, and you won't know that unless you start living with no regrets. And I mean, if any of you guys are being bullied out there right now, whether you're 12, or whether you're 20, or whether you're 30, or whether you're 40, everyone gets bullied, everyone can get bullied, and it's stupid people out there that just think that they can pick on you because you're different than them, when they should be respecting you. Because I mean, people respect people that can be themselves. It's the scare, self-conscious, stupid-ass people that bully the ones that are above them and that are better than them, basically is what I'm saying. And to Jared, if you're watching this, I told him I would give him a shout out because he said he watched my YouTube channel, and I just want to say that I love you, and you're a beautiful person inside and out, and don't change. And you know what? If every single one of you guys could comment below in the comments or make a video response telling me of a time you got bullied, or a time your friend got bullied and you had to help them out, I think that would be really, really great. And I mean, it would show people that they're not alone. Everybody gets bullied. Everybody goes through it. It's not a big deal. It's just gay people go through it way worse because we're targets. I mean, we're different. We're different than anybody else, right off the bat. You know what I mean? So it gives people stuff to say about us. But yeah, I think that if you guys leave a video response or a comment, it could help people that are feeling really, really alone right now, if they're going through a hard time. So I really, really look forward to see what you guys say. And until I see you guys next time, stay gorgeous.